main presenter today is Mr. David Youngs. David is the Assistant Vice President and Senior Mortgage Consultant at Progressive Lending Solutions. David brings with him a ton of knowledge on home financing. Your other presenter for today is Tommy McNuckles. Tommy is a realtor with Keller Williams. He is also an independent licensed social worker. Between being a realtor and a social worker, Tommy has many years of helping clients with their needs. With that, I'll hand it over to Tommy to explain why is homeownership important.
Homeownership is important for several reasons, but the reason I'll start with is my own personal reason. I bought my first property back in 2002. I didn't understand a lot about home ownership at that point in time. I really didn't understand about my finances as well. And that property I ended up doing a short sale on. And then soon after I got back in the race and I purchased another property, but I developed a plan to financially put myself in the best position to purchase a home. And I think that's so important when you are looking to buy a home is getting all the steps in place to do the things you need to do. And I know my esteemed colleague, David, will then expand on that in his portion. But those are the things you definitely have to do before you get everything going. Racing to a realtor doesn't solve anything before you get your steps done. You need to get your steps done first, and then you can move yourself into a position to understand what it is you're purchasing, understanding your purchasing power, and then knowing how to live in the home that you're going to buy.
Focus of this entire webinar series that Andrew's put together, this expanded wallet. The goal here is we want to save you money. Common way people buy a home, they start online, they find the realtor, they go find financing. They may or may not get approved. They're stressed out, they're sad, they're disappointed all the way through. And then a month, 2 months later, they finally talk to someone that knows what they're doing with the mortgage side. We figure it out. We understand exactly where they're at. We put the steps and strategies in place. Now you're going to be a homeowner. But you started off on such a difficult journey that didn't need to be this difficult. And every single day, I talk to someone that has gone through this or is going through this. It's so common because there's not a lot of education out there. So as we have in the slide there, there's the common way and then the better way to do it. Start with the mortgage professional, then go to the realtor, then go to the house. When we do it in that order, it's a piece of cake. When it comes to that pre-approval, what you really want is to help a seller understand that you have a really good chance of buying this house. If the seller looks at 10 pre-approvals, which is, by the way, the common theme in the market right now, there is more buyers than there are sellers. So when you go find that perfect house, it is the one. Guess what? You're competing against 9 other people thinking the same thing. How are you going to win that offer? You get one from an actual licensed mortgage professional that can actually explain and walk through with the listing agent and the sellers, this is exactly where we're at, what's been done, what you can expect in the process. Of those pre-approvals, which one do you think you're probably going to take? The pre-generated one from the banks or the online companies, or one from a licensed professional that's writing it? Think about if you had a signed letter from a private attorney that was working on your behalf for a legal purpose versus you went on LegalZoom.com, printed off a form yourself. Which one's going to carry more weight in making that legal case? So having that quality pre-approval is the key. And we want to make sure that all these pieces are being covered. The factors that determine if you're going to be pre-approved for a home loan, what are those factors? It comes down again, I touched on it earlier, credit, income, and assets. You need all three. Let's say you got $1 million in the bank, you got $1 million a year of income, and you got a 480 credit score. Guess what? You're not gonna buy the house, very likely. If you have an 800 credit score, you make $1 million a year, but you got no cash, not gonna buy the house. And same on the other one, if you got great credit, you got plenty of money, but you don't have enough income, you're not going to get the house. It's not one trumps the other one. You have to have all three to make it work. So there are hundreds and hundreds of things that we need to look at and cover. It's not just, do you have a good credit score? How has your payment history been? What's your credit utilization look like? How much of your credit cards are you using for their limits? Do you have rental history? Can we prove it? Do you have any collections, charge-offs, judgments, tax liens, any other mortgages maybe in the past that are floating around out there? Maybe you're a second-time home buyer and you got an old mortgage that wasn't satisfied or recorded correctly. So there's a lot of things that go into that. Income, same thing. You make $1 million a year, but you're self-employed. So as the government allows you to, you write it all off. I don't make any income because I don't want to pay any taxes. That's totally fine. It's legal. But you're not going to get the house most likely because you don't have any income to show. So there's a lot of things that we have to focus on when it comes to this. It's not just simply, do you have a good credit score? Here you go, you're pre-approved. It's not about the letter. In some cases, Tommy can probably relate to this. Even if you have the exact same offer, I've seen this happen, or maybe there's a better one. I've run into this before. There's a better offer that's come in, but and yours is a little less, but because you have the stronger pre-approval, they're going with your offer because they'd rather ensure their best chance of closing than, you know, get a couple thousand more out of the sale. They just want to get the deal done. So it's a big, big factor, this pre-approval. So an important takeaway from this is just you can get a pre-approval from anywhere, but just know they are not created equal. You want to make sure you're working with someone that is licensed, preferably. And even if they aren't, even if it's just a bank employee, which is, you know, banks at a bank, you do not need a license to originate a loan if you work for a bank. Even if you're working with someone like that, they may be experienced. Maybe they do have 20, 30 years in the business. They know what they're doing. Great. That person probably will take good care of you. But you want to stay away from the online companies and the fly-by-night companies, the ones that maybe aren't going to do their due diligence. And if you apply for a pre-approval and they don't go through questions, they don't ask you things, they don't dial everything in and detail this, you probably want to get a second pre-approval. Best way that you can handle that or work with that is to actually work with someone that knows what they're doing so that they can coach you through them all so you're not missing something that could be saving you money or help you accomplish what you need, even though every other bank you've talked to says it can't be done. And that's just one little plug for our company. That's one nice thing about being a broker is we work with multiple banks all over the country that can shop and figure out what mortgage is the best for you personally. So it's a tailored product. It's a tailored consult. It's a very different process than your average mortgage company. There are a few things that I wanted to share regarding action steps. First, set up a date to take action. When do you want to buy? When do you want to be in that home? So if you want to be in your place, as an example, let's just say by May 2021, then today, now is the time we should be having the conversation about what you can qualify for and action steps you can take to get into that position. If you're thinking you want to buy in 3 months, a year and a half, now is the time to do it. It doesn't change the timeline. There's no reason why we would not want to do this sooner because it allows us to be able to put a plan in place and help you through it. The more time we have to work on things, work on your credit, get the income in place, the easier it's going to be later. Regarding your credit, that's one of the number one driving factors. When you're looking at your credit online, a lot of people probably have those Capital One or Mint.com, whatever it is, click here for your free credit score. Those are really great free options. Watch that, track it. Don't pay attention to the score itself because the scores that you see are not the same scores lenders see. You got to knock about 20 to 40 points at least off those scores that you see from what we see. It's two completely different scoring calculations. But watch the score and watch, more importantly, the movement of the score. If you see your score online is, say, 660 and you want to be at 740, well, don't pay attention to what it says exactly, but pay attention to how much does it move. You need it to move that 40, 50, 100 points, whatever it is you're trying to hit. Get a budget in place. Your loan consultant can help you with that, but get a budget in place. Start building your savings. Not only do you need enough for the down payment, There's also closing costs, taxes, insurance, miscellaneous things that sometimes got to get paid within the contract terms. And underwriters really want to see that you have some money left over after we close. If you have $10,000 in the bank and all $10,000 goes to this house and you are broke going into this house, that is a problem. You are setting yourself up for financial failure. How are you going to make your first payment? How are you going to pay for your furniture, curtains, paint, all the things that go into that? You need a lawnmower if you have a yard. I didn't think about that. So make sure you have that savings in place and that cushion on top of what you need. And then lastly, don't change anything without talking to the loan consultant first. Don't change jobs. Don't quit your job. Don't open new accounts. Don't close accounts. Don't pay things off. Don't go out and do that 0% financing or whatever it might be. Don't do anything major, because as small as it might seem, even something as simple as putting some cash that you have at home in your bank account can cause a problem with being able to qualify for that home mortgage. So make sure no changes without having that conversation first. There's other things you can do, but those were some that I thought of that just really powerful things. If everyone does this, it's going to set you up for financial success. This whole process is going to be a piece of cake for you. The best place that you can go to get information on all of this is to identify your mortgage consultant you want to work with and let them guide and coach you through all of this. So NMLSConsumerAccess.org. You can actually look up every mortgage professional in the country with their credentials, if they have any government actions that have been taken against them, if they have a valid license, where they're licensed, their past employment information, all of this.